Hello, I'm Stephanie Blythe, and I have the great fortune to be the Artistic Director of the Graduate Vocal Arts Program here at Bard Conservatory. It is my very great pleasure to welcome you to this special presentation featuring 11 of our magnificent artists performing their selections for this year's Conservatory Concerto Competition. The competition was held earlier this semester, and recording these auditions was no mean feat. So I'd like to extend my gratitude to the members of the faculty and staff who made this possible, namely Frank Corliss, Mark Mankus, Emmanuel Coe, and last but not least, Anne Gabler. I also would like to extend a very special thank you to Ryan McCullough, who set up all of the AV equipment that made it possible for our singers to sing without masks with a pianist in a remote location, in this case, the room next door. You know, putting something together like this during the time of COVID, it takes a lot of ingenuity, creativity, something that we have a lot of here at Bard Conservatory. And I think that it's something that our faculty, staff, and students should be very proud of. So please enjoy this presentation, and thank you for watching.
Hi, my name is Louis Thiemann, and today I will be presenting Gustav Mahler's Lieder eines fahrenden Gesellen. It follows the story of the narrator as he loses his love, deals with the pain of that, and finally accepts it and moves on with his life.
Ganz ist ja. ging heut morgen übers Feld, da noch auf den Gräsen hing, sprach zu mir der lustge Fink, ei du Geld. Guten Morgen, ei Geld, du, wie sich seine schöne Welt, schöne Welt. Zink, zink, schön und flink, wie mir doch die Welt gefällt. Auch die Glockenblum am Feld hat mir lustig guter Ding mit den Glöckchen klinger, kling, klinger, kling. Jeden Morgen groß geschält wird sich eine schöne Welt, schöne Welt. Kling, 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 schönes Ding, wie mir doch die Welt gefällt. Heia!
Ach, was ist das für ein böser Gast?
nimmer hält Ruh, nimmer hält Rast. Nicht bei Tag, nicht bei Nacht, ich schlief. O weh, o
Niemand. I am performing Charles Griffey's Three Poems of Fiona MacLeod. Griffey's Three Poems of Fiona MacLeod is a set of songs that take us on a journey through pain, love, and passion. Fiona MacLeod was the pseudonym of William Sharp, the 19th century Scottish poet. He was a writer who dabbled in the occult and had a deep relationship with spirit, and this was clear in his works. The first in the cycle, The Lament of the Inn and the Frau, is a person grappling with their mortality. The second, Thy Dark Eyes to Mine, is an ode to a lover and a promise to exhibit never-ending devotion. And the final, The Rose of the Night, calls on the elements of nature to display ultimate passion and infatuation. Sonically, Griffey's emulates the mood that Sharp sets by calling on medieval ancient sounds, modal harmonies in the piano in which feelings of mysticism and wonder are evoked. The sweeping vocal lines in all three pieces work as connective tissue to deliver us with a feeling of release and drama. Singing this piece deeply inspires me not only to continue singing the works of Charles Griffey and continue exploring the works of Fiona MacLeod, as well as taking the pleasure in exploring the unknown, never taking life for granted, and always loving with passion.
Faster than a bolero,
in a major tonality and often accompanied by castanets. The text presents a well-known morality tale about those who live in glass houses not throwing rocks. Asturiana is from the Asturian region of Spain, a song of lament, with both the singer and a nearby tree weeping for the singer's grief. Jota is a delightful air, speaking of forbidden love, with its musical influence coming from the northeast of Spain, where the Jota is a popular type of Aragon dance, dating back to the Moorish people of the 12th century. The style of dance is also popular in Navarre, Valencia, and Castile. Nana is perhaps the most personal song of the set, as it is based on a lullaby that the fire's mother sang to him when he was a child. The style of the lullaby is distinct in that it is Andalusian, and while the turns and melismas in the piece give it its Spanish character, Andalusian music also draws oral influences from Africa and Asia. Canción begins to set the scene for the final song in the set by talking about romantic betrayal. Polo is a fiery call for revenge on a former lover. Its flamenco influences are palpable, with the somewhat harsh rhythmic piano part evoking zapateado, a flamenco dance involving the dancer stomping loudly on the floor. I hope you enjoy this tasting platter of Spanish music.
Thank you. My name is Chang-Yuan Liu, and please let me introduce you to Poems of Life, an orchestral song cycle written for countertenor, solo cello, and orchestra by American composer Kenneth Fuchs on 12 poems of Judith G. Wolf. Dr. Wolf's expressive poems take us on a memorable journey through everyday life. The support of family and friends, the joy of love, and the pain of loss. In Fuchs' own words, the poems weave a narrative of eternal love, the pain of loss through death, emotional transformation through grief, and spiritual enlightenment. The cycle was written quite recently in 2016 and had its premiere in April 2017 with the Virginia Symphony Orchestra, with countertenor Arya Nesbong Cohen singing the solo. Later that year, the recording of this cycle with the London Symphony Orchestra, along with a couple of other compositions by Fuchs, won the 2018 Grammy Award for Best Classical Compendium. Fuchs captures the essence of the poems with breathtaking harmonies and melodies and intricate word paintings, and creates this dreamlike world that really allows the text to shine. As heart-wrenching as it can be, the warm aftertaste lingers as they inspire people on how one can perceive death. It has been such an honor and pleasure to work on this cycle, and even more pleasurable to work with Ryan McCullough. How much I wish that there's a second camera capturing the beauty of this thing. Anyway, without further ado, please enjoy Poems of Life. Thank you.
Swollen eyelids, sleeping Samantha Martin. I am a first-year soprano. I will be presenting Michael Chani Will's three songs, Budapest 1944. The texts of each of these pieces honors Holocaust victims. The first piece, the Waldsee Postcard, features texts from postcards that were used as Nazi propaganda, forcing Jews to write home to their families, saying that they were well and very happy in their new location. The second piece, The Siege, features diary entries from Harry Hirschler, a distant relative of the composer, as she noted down the transition of Nazi takeover in her country. The final piece, The Last Letter, is the final letter that the composer's great-grandmother, Irene, was able to send to her two children hours before she was killed, wishing them well and sending her love.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi, my name is Wayne Arthur Paul, and I'm a baritone currently finishing up my studies in the vocal arts program at Bard Conservatory. The next selection you're going to be hearing is entitled Songs of Separation by composer William Grant Still. They were published in 1949 and feature poetry by Paul Laurence Dunbar, Haitian folklorist Philippe Toby Marcellin, and three writers of the Harlem Renaissance, Arnaud Bontemps, County Cullen, and Langston Hughes. Each of these poems have their own unique identity, and they're weaved together musically by composer William Grant Still, and they take us on a journey that is at times obsessive, a bit humorous, and with the final song entitled A Black Pierrot, ultimately triumphant. Thank you for tuning in, and I hope that you enjoyed these songs.
Ma tête dans mes mains.
wrapped her soul in a lace of lies, with a prime deceit to pin it. And I thought I was gaining a fearsome prize, so I staked my soul to win it. We wed and parted on her complaint, and both were a bit of barter, though I'll confess that I'm no saint. I swear that she's no martyr. Passing day, we would not know, but for the night when it has slipped away. It has lived, except a gleam across the dreamer's face.
To let you into my world and imagination for this piece.
embark on a journey into the night. All alone, the vast wonderland opens up, and I begin to see the beauty around me, despite the loneliness I feel. I stumble upon a reed shore, and I think of the one I love, and I hear their voice falling into the pond. Nightingales soar above me and sing throughout the night, and for a moment, all is well in my world. I see love in the midst of isolation, and words begin to cease after image surrounds me and wholly fills me up.
Trinke einsamkeit. halb Sonnenschein. Der liebe Abend blickt so still herein. Ein Fäulein rot kischt hart im Ofen Lob und Not. Gab uns Ruhe.